Hello, in this video I will show some tips and tricks for the usage of the optimization techniques on a real suspension bridge. In the example in the CSM.dat folder, optimize, there is a file CSM28 suspension bridge real, and I started very simple with this input system, so I just made a straight input. That's very, very easy. So the first task is to find a form for the main cable. For this I made a simple ASA run where I fixed set 3 all X and Y displacements so that I am only interested in the vertical set deformation. I only activate the tower and the hangers, the main cable, and we can play now with this pre-stress of the main cable. If I have a high value, I get this shape. If I have a low pre-stress, I get this value, and so I can very quickly choose the form I want. If I now run a system update in ASA where I take this load case that I just calculated and then open the animator, I immediately get this picture, because the update run really changed the nodal coordinates. With this system I now make a first estimated pre-stress run, so I estimate again the pre-stress for the main cable and the hangers so that it is about correct, and I end up in maybe this bending moment, and this deflection 4 meters is quite high, but it's only a first estimated pre-stress. Now we want to make an optimization on the final system, as on the little example in the other video. If we want to get a target for U set for one node here on the superstructure, of course it is very clear that we can use the pre-stress or shortening of this hanger in a best way. At the pier we want also that this node has a very good U-set result, so we can give a lengthening to this pier on the bottom. Also at the top of the pier we really want U-set equals 0, so the architectural shape shall be at traffic opening target U-set class 0, and we can also give a lengthening on this beam to reach this target, because the normal force of the cable will shorten the pier. Again we write everything in one line. The scalable load case is here the lengthening, and the target is U-set equals 0. When we have an optimization of the vertical nodes, then sometimes the nodes also get a little horizontal deflection, and we can adjust this by getting an additional target, Ux gleich 0 for this node, and the scalable load case shall always be a pair of lengthening on the left and shortening on the right. So if I use this scalable load case, I only move this node to the left and to the right and do not disturb the other effects. This of course may be very important if you have a real curved bridge where the hangers shall be really parallel. Now we can calculate all scalable load cases on the final system in one run, so 100 load cases in one run, and therefore we can frozen the stiffness from the first run that we did with the estimated pre-stress, and calculate all load cases with this frozen stiffness. Frozen stiffness means it is a stiffness but including geometric effect of the cables in the stiffness. The CSM can Now set up an equation system, solve it, and here we again see the first estimate that we did. And here we see the my after the first optimization. So we see the bending moment is now perfectly balanced because the UZ coordinates are in the architectural shape, and therefore also the bending moments are very good. So what do we have now? Under dead load and additional dead load, we now have an equilibrium geometric nonlinear in the stress system. The superstructure is in the architectural position. The bending moment is perfectly balanced. The tower head is in the correct position. We have no tower bending, and we get the unstressed cable length, because the program of course can measure the distance between these two nodes and knows the normal force, and so this length minus the normal force elongation is the unstressed cable length. Now we come to the construction stage analysis. This is a little bit more complex, and we see here a nice picture of this banana shape of a bridge in China. The procedure is shown here, you can read it in detail if you want. The first step is we start with the system primary load case 1001 that we had just analyzed. That was the equilibrium in the traffic opening system. We now switch off a lot of elements that we do not have in the beginning. That means the superstructure and the hangars. And as we use this load case as a primary load case, the stress in the main cable of course now is too high, and the main cable goes up a little bit. Now we want to make a CSM run where we activate our segments step by step by step. The most important input here now is the command length 0 that defines when we insert a hanger, the hanger shall be inserted with the unstressed length of this primary load case traffic opening. So we can do as if the hangers have been prefabricated with a given length, and this given length is then used for the CSM run. To clear this, here the four steps that run in one step afterwards, we have the last step. We lift the new segment, we adjust it so that it's here tangentially and weld it together, and then we adjust the hanger that the hanger has the unstressed length that we pre-calculated. This can be done in one step. We insert the element and insert the hanger with the correct position and the correct length. Again, you can think when we insert an element, we insert the element stress-free, that it is hanging on a crane or lying on a formwork. So it is always inserted stress-free in the tangential system control cantilever 2. This works very fine, but if we now come to the abutment, we do not attach in the right position, because when we come here in the construction stage, the additional dead load G2 is not on the system, therefore we have not enough weight and we come a little bit too high to our bridge. So what can we do? I decided to use a little bit of ballast, then weld it together, and then to remove the ballast. And this ballast can now also be optimized by the optimization tool. So the ballast is a scalable load case, and in the result, the target is that the bending moment in my superstructure is very good. This we can see here, we can have a scalable load case and the target is a beam bending moment in a specific stage that we want. The same happens at the pier. We first can lift here the support. We put a little bit ballast on, attach to the pier, put the ballast away, ballast right, attach to the pier, ballast away, and then adjusting this level so that the bending moment in the superstructure is okay. The reason why we need the support lowering here is that when we attach with the last segment here on the right side, we do not want to weld in a kink. So we have to adjust here in a level that we do not insert a kink when we weld it together. So we have to adjust this afterwards. So with this, we get a very, very good bending moment in the final stage, and this was the bending moment before. Now to summarize, we had our first run including construction stages before optimization and after optimization of the ballast and these little corrections, we really get a good bending moment including the construction stages. And the deformation is only 40 millimeters, but for a free span of 2,500 meters. Now a short look to the animator. We have here our load case 1001. We set the magnitude of the deformation to 1.0. And if we now look to some load cases, the first load case was, we stop the animation, only the hanger. We see the main cable goes up a little bit. Now we take the first segment into our system. The next segment, we add segment and segment after another. And you see magnitude 1.0, that's a real picture on site. We get this nice banana shape for our bridge. We go on and see we now attach to the piers and we attach a little bit too high because the additional dead load G2 is not yet on the system. So we go on and also on this side we can attach quite well to our bridge. Here a short overview of what we did. The main trick was that we pre-analyzed the unstressed hanger length on the final system and used this unstressed length for the construction stages. Now a short word to the influence line valuation LR. If we now have our stressed system, we can also calculate traffic loads with a frozen stiffness. Therefore, we make an ASA run just before LR, where we set this S-fix frozen stiffness. ASA makes a equation system, a stiffness matrix, and LR can use this frozen stiffness then. We can also then get with Sophie load an LR load positioning, maybe for the maximum bending moment in midspan. This would be the most critical load position. And that's it was. With this, we have now finished our suspension bridge. And now the last words on closing a gap. If you have really problems on closing a gap and you come with your cantilevers together like this or like this, so don't worry about this. You must do an optimization on the forces and not on the deformations if you work on construction stages. This problem of the gap can always be solved with an easy pre-camber. So thanks for listening and goodbye.